Today, I'll tell you the truth about the most common myths about hair. And stay tuned until the end of the episode for the question of the day. If you answer it correctly, you'll have a chance to win a free skincare product. Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. There's just as much misinformation flying around about hair as there is about skincare. So today, I'll tell you six of the worst myths about your hair. Let's get started. Myth number one, hereditary hair loss is caused by maternal genes. Actually, the heredity of hair loss is very confusing and complex and not nearly as simple as just being inherited from mom. I'm sure you can blame a lot of stuff on your mom, but no longer can you blame your hair loss on her. Myth number two, if you shampoo less often, your scalp will gradually produce less oil. In fact, if you shampoo less often, your hair and scalp will be dirtier and more oily as the oils accumulate and trap more dirt. The only thing that regulates oil production is your level of male hormone in your blood. Period. End of story. Nothing else affects oil production in your scalp or skin. Myth number three. If you wax long enough, the hair will stop growing. If stopping unwanted hair were only that easy. Actually, if you wax long enough, you'll get more and more ingrown hairs, which is neither very attractive nor fun, especially when they're painful. Myth number four, hair loss is caused by clogs in scalp pores. The reality is that hair loss may be aggravated by uncontrolled dandruff, which may increase hair loss, but has nothing to do with clogged pores. Myth number five, frequent hair cutting makes hair grow faster. The only thing that I know that makes scalp hair grow faster is finasteride, also known as Propecia, which is used by men to stimulate hair growth. Bimatoprost, known as Latisse, can cause eyelashes to grow faster, but it's much too expensive to consider for scalp hair, even if ongoing studies do demonstrate that it works. And last but not least, myth number six, frequent shampooing makes hair fall out. Shampooing will only make hairs fall out which are ready to fall out and would have fallen out in the next day or two by themselves even if you didn't shampoo. Gentle and normal shampooing never affects normal hairs adversely. So there you have it, six of the biggest myths about hair and where they fall short. And in future DermTV episodes, I'll share some more. Now for today's skincare trivia. Answer today's question correctly, and you'll be entered in a drawing to win a free skincare product. Submit your answers at dermtv.com/trivia within 3 days of this episode's airing. Today's question is, what's the main complication after waxing to remove hair, which is one of the reasons why laser hair removal is the best technique for hair removal? And by the way, laser hair removal also cures this complication. And don't forget, you can find the answer to all questions in past DermTV episodes. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.